don't happen, it don't happen, it don't tell her, it don't tell her. No, a Google, be careful, a Google Jam Express, that's not it. But in the educational sense of things, it don't happen. Homeschooling in Nigeria has now become a reality. You will learn to appreciate your teachers. You will learn to appreciate the hard work our educators are putting in. But let's face it, COVID-19 has changed the way we live our lives, including how our children, how our wards are getting educated. So now the responsibility is on a lot of parents and guardians. My name is Isabella Akinseye, and welcome to Correct Student. This is a channel that we live by. Our motto, our mantra, our hashtag is always learning. We're always learning. So, I mean, if we always learn, then we'll learn this homeschooling thing together. So today's vlog, I'm looking at tips to help you crack this homeschooling thing, like hack this homeschooling. So it's a correct student guide to homeschooling in Nigeria. So let's get to it. Number one, where do I start from? That's what you're probably thinking, like, I don't even know what to do. Don't worry. Number one, start from the scheme of work. The scheme of work is the first place to go. And, you know, back in the days, I don't know if they call it scheme of work. You might know it as the curriculum. You might know it as the termly outline. But basically, at the beginning of every term, you're given the scheme of work. That way, you're able to plan ahead. You can read ahead. When I was in school, they used to call me Efiko, someone that likes to read and read, or Jackie, always Jackie. But the thing is, with the scheme of work, you can see topics in advance. If you have free time, you can read. You also are guided. So as a parent, as a guardian, start with the scheme of work, and the schools will be so happy to provide that for you. You can also check it in your children's notebooks. You can check it in the materials they are giving. And you know what? That scheme of work will help you, because there you can see what has been covered and what is still pending. And one great way to familiarize yourself with it is to even have a chit chat, like gist. I didn't say be all strict, or have a chit chat with your child, with your ward, about what they're enjoying in that particular subject, what they've covered, how their teacher approached the subject, and you learn a lot. So you've gotten your scheme of work. Now let's move to number two. You have to read and study the textbooks. Yes. You too, you have to be a correct student just the way your child or ward is. You have to ask them, please bring your textbook, start reading it. You might be like, ah, how will I go? Sometimes some of these modern textbooks actually do summaries. So you might want to do it, you know, the easy way, the shortcut. You just go and read the summary. Again, you can leverage the internet. Some textbooks actually put online resources so that you can still go online and still get additional content. So start reading the textbooks. Start familiarizing yourself with the terms, with the diagrams, with the equations, with the pictures, with the resources that your children, your wards are learning from. So important. Now let's move to number three. Have a go at past questions. Yes, you heard me right. Your children and your wards, they are sitting for exams. Do you know what it feels like? Like your heart will be beating. I know some of you, you've not written an exam in 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, maybe even 30 years. And you just have these high expectations from your children, your wards, the people you're looking after, that, ah, you must get this, you must get this. When I was your age, I got this, I got that. Okay, you too. Sit down and have a go at the past questions. What it does is that, one, you build some kind of trust with your child, with your ward, because they know that, look, we're in this thing together. And then also you can see what they're going through. It's easier for the conversations that follow. And then with past questions, let's face it, a lot of them come with the mark scheme. So it's a good way to actually test yourself. And you know, like we say on this channel, hashtag always learning. So yes, you have a bit of free time, you're learning. Learn with your child, learn with your ward. Have a go at past questions. Number four, leverage online resources. Ah, the internet. Sometimes I wonder, what would we have done without the internet? Now, I was born in the late
1980s, and we didn't have the internet then, so you'd have to go to the library. You had that Encyclopedia Britannica, you had that uncle, auntie, teacher that you could ask all the questions and they had all the answers. You had to do the hard work. But now, with literally the click of a button, like, you can type something and that is it. You have so much resources at your disposal. You need to leverage online resources. There are podcasts, there are audiobooks, there are YouTube videos like this one, there are articles, there's so much online. But do your due diligence. It doesn't start and end with Wikipedia. I remember being in my first week or second week at the University of Cambridge, where I studied education with English and drama. And me too, I went to go and reference Wikipedia. My lecturer was like, Wikipedia, no, that doesn't work for academic work. Like, you have to go to proper sources. So start with the internet, start with your online resources. Number five, and this one is very dear to my heart, and I'll tell you why. It is plug into educational programming. So growing up again in the early 90s in Nigeria, I watched a lot of TV, NTA. We had things like Kidivision 101, we had Speak Out, we had very educational shows on TV. And when I went to the United States for my fifth and sixth grade, the content there was great. Like, I had things like Krat Creatures, Wishbone. I learned from The Magic School Bus about science. And throughout my life, I've seen myself going back to television, going back to radio, going back to the internet to really consume educational programming. And why I say it's so dear to me is because I love to create edutaining content. That's content that's educational, but also entertaining. And one of such content is my television show called Africana Literati TV Show. Now, if you search on YouTube, Africana Literati TV Show, you get videos, you see highlights from the show. And the show was started to promote book reading, to also showcase the richness of our African writing, our African literature, our African authors. So if you're looking for educational programming, why not start? I mean, they say charity begins at home. So you can start an Africana Literati TV Show and you get book reviews, you see top five countdowns, you see interviews with people in the literary space, you see vox pops, you also see fan connect where we share feedback from our fans. It's a whole lot to keep you entertained, or should I say edutained. And that kind of programming, I mean, Africana Literati is just one, but you actually have channels on TV that are dedicated to educational programming. You have radio content, you also have online content, you have a host of educational providers that are using the media for their own benefit in delivering their content. So please, let's plug into educational programming. I told you that this one was dear to me, right? So now let's move to number six. And you know how they say all work and no play makes Jack and Jill bored kids. That's my way of completing it. Number six is about breaking it up with co-curricular activities. Yes, they want to learn. We hope they do. They are following your learning, they are following your teaching, they are getting used to this homeschooling, because as is also new for you, it's also new to the children, to your wards, thinking, how is mommy, how is auntie, how is grandma, how is grandpa, how is uncle teaching me? They too, they are also learning. But you know what? After a while, the brain, it will just be getting hot, like literally, it will just be too much. It is not morning to night, school. Even when they're in school, don't they have short break, long break, recess? I mean, when I was in secondary school in Nigeria, Fridays, we had time dedicated to co-curricular activities. So that's not the time to forget the co-curricular activities. But remember, in the era of COVID-19, social distancing, so it's important that you choose co-curricular activities that do not require body contact. Yeah, this is a good time to start learning a new language, to pick up arts and crafts, to learn an instrument, to discover new hobbies. And I mean, there are things you can do by yourself, and you know, the children don't feel cooped up, and they're just learning. They're doing fun things. So co-curricular activities, sports, for example, that don't require body contact. Those are great ideas. Break it up with co-curricular activities. And number 7, which is my final tip in this whole Correct Student Guide to Homeschooling in Nigeria, is join virtual support groups and communities. Like, you don't want your head to literally explode. Like, if you see some of the comments from parents online, you know they are really trying, from guardians online who are dealing with children at home. It's not easy, you know, mommy, auntie, uncle, help me, do this, do that. You know, in between that, you're thinking of working from home remotely. You're thinking of getting yourself hydrated, keeping your immune system going. You're preparing food for them. You're taking care of them, bathing them, caring for them. You know, there's a lot to deal with. And then they've now added homeschooling on top. Like, who sent me? That's what you'll be thinking. But the truth is that you are not alone. And that's why it's important to join communities, safe spaces, support groups, virtual, because again, social distancing. Like, this is not the time that you're now going to plan one meetup in one of the shops that, okay, let's all get together. No, we can make use of technology. There are so many apps out there. Some are free, some are paid for, freemium, that you can use. The social media, you can connect there. And really, we're all in this together. To be honest, a lot of us are winging it. Like, we're trying different things, seeing what works. And that's the place where you can exchange experiences. That's the place where you can get good energy, positive vibes. You can also get appreciated. You can learn from other people. So please, no man, no woman, none of us, we're not islands. And that's what COVID-19, I feel, is bringing out, that we'll still find ways to communicate. We'll still find ways to socialize with people, even if we're on the lockdown. And really, if you're thinking of social media, if you've not already gone to our social media platforms, this is a great time to go. On Instagram and Facebook, just search for Correct Student. On Twitter, it's slightly different. It's Correct Student 1. And you can also check out our website, which is www.correctstudent.com. And while you're at it, make sure you like, you follow, you drop a comment, you share, you repost. And if you haven't already subscribed to our YouTube channel, what are you waiting for? You want me to do another? It don't happen. No, I'm not going to do that. But please subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit me up in the comment section. Give me a like, a thumbs up, tap that bell so you can get notifications of new content. And do let me know what you like to see on this channel. Remember, we're all learning in this period, and it's my channel, it's your channel, it's our channel. You know, if you're a Correct Student, you're always learning. And I believe as long as you have breath in you, you're learning, you keep learning, and that makes you a Correct Student. So thank you so much for tuning in. I'm Isabella Akinseye, and I can't wait to come your way with yet another vlog on Correct Student. Bye-bye.